Everywhere, really. Located at 110 Pine Street in East Rochester, but generally everywhere. I don't really work out of an office in a cleaning company.
And your spouse?
Single.
Single?
Cat, Tiggy. That's it. Just my cat.
Any pets?
Whoa,
yeah.
Pet's name?
Tiggy.
Tiggy?
Yep, he's my little buddy.
Hobbies and interests?
Hobbies, interests, martial arts, exercising, reading, movies.
Meditation.
I go on 10-day meditation retreats, 20-day meditation retreat soon. They're silent and stuff, so, yeah.
You've lived in East
Rochester all your life? Nope, started in Webster, moved to the city, and then ended up in East Rochester.
I'm not even going to ask you previous jobs. You've been doing that.
Yeah, I've been
so
doing this
long.
Forever. Actually, the only other job I've had since that is when the economy collapsed. I worked at Target stocking shelves at night while I rebuilt my business. So that was my look at hell.
Your burning desire.
Well, I have one. Live in the moment. That's where I am all the time.
Yeah. Key to success.
Key to success, work harder than everybody else and be honest. You'll make a buck lying to people, but you won't make $2 in the future lying to people. It'll come back to you. It always does. You get a stink on you.
So nice. And something nobody knows about you.
Was thinking about this, Austin with the arrow and Mike last week with the snake. So been doing martial arts my whole life. And I was going for a test, and because this is what you do when you're in your 20s, my teacher goes, we're gonna shoot an arrow at you out of a compound bow, and you're gonna have to block it. And we went downstairs, long hallway. My friend took his arrow out and shot it right in my chest, and I got out of the way. It stuck in the concrete wall.
It's like Jackass.
Oh, it's tougher than Jackass. Didn't think twice about it. That's what you do when you're that's what you do before your frontal cortex is fully developed. But there's a part of me that still looks at it and goes, yeah, I'd do it again. It was worth it. But anyways, so I wanted to give a presentation today. If somebody could tell me, I want to keep it to 9 minutes. I'm going to take a minute for questions. So I'm going to stop at 9 minutes no matter where I am. I want to talk today about what chemicals do and why you want to use the right chemicals, and then when you sanitize. Because what I don't want you to do is pick up the 409 and sanitize everything. That's bad for you. You don't want to kill all the germs in your house. Get that idea out of your head. We know now antibiotics and hand sanitizers are bad for you. They make you sick. So you don't. Do I have hand sanitizer in my house? Yeah, every once in a while I feel like washing my hands, so I'll do this. 10 seconds, then I wipe it off. If you keep it on your hand for 30 seconds, then you're gonna kill all the bacteria on your hands. You don't want to do that. Okay. So soil is defined as dirt where you don't want it to be. Okay. Soils that don't dissolve in water but can be chemically blended into water are called binders, okay? Grease, oil, animal fat, those are binders that stick to things, okay? So that's generally what you want to clean off, right? Soils that dissolve in water are called water soluble. Those are sugar, juice, things like that. We use the pH scale to clean. So all your cleaners are based on the pH scale. On one side we have acid, the other side we have alkaline, okay? So if you're gonna clean a surface, you have to know which chemical to use on that surface. We know bathroom cleaners don't work well in the kitchen, and I'm gonna go over that in a minute. And the chemical strength of that, of course, is based on the pH. So acid is 0, neutral is 7, alkaline is 14. When you clean a surface, you want that surface to go to 7 when you're done cleaning it. Then you're going to wipe it away. All right? So acids, this side of the scale, is 0. Grapefruit juice, lemon juice, stomach fluids. Common soils, most dirt outside, soda, beer, coffee, vinegar, human, animal vomit, vegetables, fruits, and flowers. Again, animals get sick in the house, that sort of thing, so you clean it up with that end of the scale. Alkaline would be lye, which is on the alkaline end of the scale, it's 13 to 14. The scale goes up to 14. Bleach is 12, ammonia is 10. All right, I'm going to get into some of this in a minute, why I'm mentioning these numbers.
So washing any surface is going to be using one of those two chemical compounds, either an alkaline or an acid, okay? Acids clean alkaline surfaces. Alkaline chemicals clean acid surfaces. When chemicals are mixed correctly, dirty water then becomes neutral, and static electricity is deactivated or the soil binders are removed. So static electricity a lot of times will actually hold dirt. So you'll clean your carpets, and I've seen this so many times. You clean your carpets, and 2 days later, the cleaning company left and the stain comes back. Well, why is that? Because they didn't remove all the static electricity from the carpet. And that static electricity held on to the dirt that actually got caught in the chemicals that were in the carpet when they tried to extract it. So it disappears for a little while, and then all of a sudden it comes back. We actually just did a job the other day and that happened. I saw my guy and I go, oh, the carpet, that goes, well, whole floor was covered in stains and one of them came back. And I said, well, we've got to go back and fix it. So common alkaline surfaces, so that's the end of the scale that's alkaline, are your restroom and shower, soap and detergent, salt and ice residues. So you'll see a lot of salt, obviously, in the middle of winter when you go in and out of buildings, you'll see the ice tracks, and you would use the acid to remove those. Mineral deposits and rust. To clean, you only need to know if something's gonna have to be cleaned with an acid or an alkaline. Binders keep soil glued to the surface. So that's what you're looking to do. You're looking to loosen up what's actually holding the thing to the surface. So there's two ways soils are held to a surface. Static electricity, where it'll stick like a magnet, or binders, where it sticks like glue. And that's when you'll see the glue is the greases, the animals, the animal fat, and things like that. So I put this together last week and I get a chance to look at it yesterday. So when you have to clean that surface, so let's say you walked up to, you're in your kitchen and you want to clean the surface and you just made some chicken, you gotta get that animal fat off of there. So what do? That's when you're gonna mix your chemical, you're gonna have your cleaner ready, you're gonna spray it on the surface, you're gonna let it sit for about a minute. Then all you need to do is walk up with a rag and wipe it away. If you really want to be technical about it, exposing yourself to chemicals and spraying them isn't necessarily good for you either. What I don't want you to do is get sick from cleaning. So what a lot of people are recommending now is that you actually take your chemicals and you have them in a container. And you just keep wet rags in the container. And when you need to clean your surface, you take the rag, you rinse a little bit, and you wipe the surface. You let it sit there for a minute. Then you're going to come back with a clean rag and wipe it off. That way you're not actually spraying the chemicals and exposing yourself to you're exposing your liver to the toxins and getting it in your skin, getting it, absorbing it through your eyes or through your nose. And I've always looked at it like this. In jiu-jitsu, we had an idea. I don't know if this is a real medical term or not, but we used to call it like micro injuries, where you get somebody in a wrist lock and you let them kind of crank it in. You'd sit there and you go, oh yeah, that, now it's in. Once or twice, that's fine. But when you're training week after week, month after month, year after year, and you do that a couple times a week, all of a sudden your wrist starts to hurt. Then you go to grab something and your wrist starts clicking. And I look at chemical exposure. Common household chemical exposure is the same way. What you don't want to do is expose yourself to those chemicals, breathing them in, getting them out of your skin constantly. Yeah, once or twice it's not a big deal. But over the long haul, you're hurting yourself by bringing those chemicals into your system, okay? So the best way to actually clean the surface is that way. So once you've cleaned the surface, when do you want to sanitize or disinfect? So sanitizer is a germicide that destroys microorganisms, germs, on a washed and rinsed surface, dishes, glasses, utensils, that sort of thing, for the period of time until the sanitizer and water evaporate. Once evaporated, germ killing ceases. Sanitizers are not designed to remove soil. So if you have soil on your counter and you spray it with a sanitizer and then wipe it off, you actually haven't done anything. You must clean the surface first, then apply the sanitizer, okay? If you just apply the sanitizer and wipe it off,
you're going to leave a sticky residue behind. We're going to go back to where the binders were. That fat's still going to be there. The binder is still on the surface. You actually haven't cleaned it. You've made the situation worse. So you have to clean it, return it back to a neutral pH with either the alkaline or the acid, make it neutral, then sanitize the surface, and then just let it dry and wipe it off later. Okay, so that's why you don't want to just go right to a sanitizer. So disinfectant detergents, a concentrated or ready-to-use solution formulated to leave a tenacious germicidal film residue on a surface after drying. The residue has an active time of 6 hours or until it gets contaminated by soil. Once contaminated, the disinfectant detergent residue loses its germ-killing effect. This type of product should not come in contact with food, be around open or unprotected food products, or be applied for food preparation services. When do you disinfect? Uncle Larry's at the house, it's a picnic. He's had too much to drink and he vomits on the floor. You can't remember if Uncle Larry has hepatitis C or not. That's when you disinfect. Okay, that's when you have to think about disinfecting. Somebody gets sick, 1 minute, okay. So, real quick, World Health Organization and the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention recommend the use of bleach for controlling the spread of pathogens that can cause infections and other health threats. For cleaning, sanitizing, disinfecting surfaces such as bathtubs, sinks, faucets, tiles, plastic toys, potty chairs, high chairs, and all that, use half a cup of Clorox regular bleach per gallon of water. That is to disinfect. Half a cup to a gallon. That's after you clean the surface. Pre-wash surface with detergent and water, then apply the sanitizing solution of bleach and water. Allow solution to contact surface for at least 5 minutes for optimal effectiveness. Afterwards, rinse and or just let it air dry. Okay, so that's the only time you need to disinfect. It's the only time you need to sanitize. Disinfect, the ratio for bleach. For cleaning food handling equipment, food contact surfaces, plastic cutting boards, stainless steel cutlery, glass, pots, pans, all that sort of thing. 2 teaspoons of Clorox bleach per gallon of water. That's it. Pre-wash surface with detergent, like I mentioned before. Then soak with sanitizing solution and bleach and water. Allow solution to contact surface for at least 2 minutes for optimal effectiveness. Drain and air dry. Okay, any questions? Yes.
Best way to clean like a Corian countertop without, so it doesn't leave streaks all over it.
Oh, so it doesn't leave streaks all over it.
With detergents, less is more.
So a lot of times when you see streaks on a surface afterwards, you're probably putting too much chemical on it. So clean it with a regular cleaning chemical. I actually brought some here with me. The chemicals in here are great chemicals to mix up, just the way I described in here. And I'll give you a website where you can go to get all that. If you use their chemicals, especially the degrease of the fast, 1, 2, 3, I have very little film left over afterwards. If you still have film afterwards, all you need to do is just spray it with water and probably wipe it off. And then it'll get, because what that film is detergent being left over. That's the idea with those soil binders being left on there. You got to get those binders off because the surface is actually clean. So once it's dry, just try rinsing with water.
Okay.
Thanks.
Yeah. So you said to clean first, then either disinfect or sanitize.
Disinfect or sanitize, yeah. Once
so
it's clean.
Bleach is a base. So you use it on an acid surface, but then it also disinfects.
We're not going to, once we've got our surface, so we're going to clean our surface with either an acid or an alkaline. So once the contaminant is gone and you've cleaned it and rinsed it, that's when you sanitize. So it shouldn't be an alkaline or a base anymore. That's already gone from the cleaning. Then you take the bleach, and the bleach is mixed in water, and I actually got that off the EPA website. So that's how they recommend doing it.
So I mean, in that case.